Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani. Today we're talking lip fillers and the duck lip versus the nice, youthful ski jump that everyone wants. So lip filler is very common around the country. It's a driver from social media, from websites to the practice, and it's a great Instagram talking point. So we naturally see a lot of lip filler patients come to the practice. What we're talking about today is that trout pout or the duck lip. And patients walk in and they say, I just want a subtle result for my lip. It's not what they're saying. They actually don't want a subtle result. They want a natural result. They don't want the animal look or the trout pout or the fish look duck lips. And today I want to talk and show you how we can get a ski jump versus the projection forward. And why is it occurring that it looks ducky? I think there's two different areas to fill. One is we got to look at the projection of the chin to the lip to the nose. And if the upper lip is already protruding forward, the bottom lip needs to be congruent and filled. That's one of the downfalls of just filling the upper lip for vertical lip lines. The vertical lip lines can be filled with our new fillers that don't draw water in. And the second point is very important because over time, if we use too hydrophilic of products, the lips become watery. They don't have a defined look to them. And in the days in 2003 prior, when we used collagen in the lips, they looked good. They looked normal because it didn't draw water in. The new products that we have that are flexible, that are very defined for filling, should be used at the lip border. And that's a key point. Injection technique here, also using the microcannula above the lip and not overfilling, also helps give that natural look. So when patients are asking for a subtle result, what they're saying is they want a youthful ski slope, but not the duck look, and it's an important distinction. In the microcannula technique, in the upper lip, in the ergotrid area, the white of the skin, helps prevent overfilling the area because there's some fluid that forms when we put the cannula in. So to your eye, you generally will underfill because it starts to look ducky. And then it settles in at day 4 to 6, and it's important to tell the patient that. It will look ducky if done properly for a day 2 or 3. Alternatively, you can underfill the area and retreat it at a month or two, depending on the patient and the patient's psychology. So I hope that helps. It's very important to create a youthful ski jump versus an abnormal duck lip just to get that projection or to get vertical lip lines. And of course, it's combination treatment. Adding a bit of neuromodulator like Botox or Dysport to the upper lip helps evert it, stops vertical lip lines. Microneedling, PRP, and other treatments in combination help us to have to rely on our fillers too much and create abnormal animal looks. Thanks for joining me today. Join us on this YouTube channel, Instagram, and Facebook for continued helpful tips. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.